every biologist knows that there's a very intimate, tight relationship between structure and function. When it tells you how something works at such a deep mechanistic level. And disease, after all, starts at the molecule.
Macromolecules are what we are made of. Everything that we have, proteins, DNA, all the parts of the cell, the ribosomes, the transcription factors, all these things make very, very large complexes. And yet, most of the times, we can only image them one at a time. What we really need to know is how they all fit together to really drive the cellular machine. The advantage of cryo-EM in general as a technique is the ability to look at very, very large complicated complexes.
If you want to imagine what it's like to use this technology, think about walking into a museum and looking at a statue and taking pictures of it and figuring out how to put those pictures together to get a three-dimensional picture. In essence, that's what we do with molecules. They are like kind of like small molecular statues, and then we take images of them from a variety of angles and orientations, and we combine these images to get a design plan and an organization for how these molecules are put together.
Cryo-EM is a disruptive technology and answers so many outstanding questions in biology. And the technology that we've brought to campus here for the very first time, it allows for the analysis of really complex macromolecular structures.
This technology is really less than 7 or 8 years old, and already tremendous advances have been made. So in that regards, it's a game changer for structural biology. Cryo-EM very soon is going to be a completely normal tool for anybody studying structural aspects of cellular function. And so people coming to UC Davis can get in on the ground floor by getting training, ability to actually operate machines directly, and to process data that really, until recently, has just not even been possible to get.
Having this technology on campus is a critical component to training modern day biologists, which is what we are all about here at UC Davis.
There are 17 core facilities on campus. 7 of them reside here in the College of Biological Sciences. And having cryo-EM is certainly part of the portfolio of technologies that any campus like UC Davis should have or aspires to have. We know that this instrument will be hugely important to people's research programs here. The top journals are publishing new work weekly that is based on cryo-EM technology. It was an essential technology to have on the Davis campus, and we're extremely excited that it's here, and we're already generating new data using this instrument.